Good morning, students. Myself J. Sushmita, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. So, in this topic, we will be seeing about edge detection in digital image processing. So, on completing this topic, you will be able to understand what is edge detection and what are the different types, that is, techniques we are using in detecting edges, and also you will be able to explain what is point, line and edge detection. So now let's see a basic introduction of edge detection. So in general, what is mean by edge detection? So we will be just using the we will be just checking out the boundaries of the objects, and we will be cutting, and that is the highlighted places will be just taken, that is the, in other words, what we can say is the boundary of the particular object will be taken and segmented. So we can see an example. So in an image, an edge is a curve that follows a path of rapid change in image intensity. So this is often associated with boundaries of an object in the scene. So you can see the example in the left side, we just have a normal image, and in the right side we can see the image with a boundary. Okay. So this is how we are separating the edges or boundaries of an. So there are two broad categories or approaches in edge detection. So first thing is a derivative approach, and second thing is pattern fitting approach. So starting up with the first one, derivative approach. So we will be detecting the edges just by following the thresholding. So thresholding in the sense, we will be using robot operator as well as four neighbor operator. Okay. So as all we know, that is how robot operator works and how four neighbor operator works. Similarly, another one thing is we can go for using Prevett and Sobel operator also. So this Prevett and Sobel operator works similar to the masking technique. We all know how a masking will be working. So we can take any number of maskers, such as 3x3 mask or 9x9 mask, whatever it is, depending upon the image, we can place the mask upon that particular image. So by placing this particular operators over the image, it can be used in cleaning the noise that are present within an image. So another one point of using this derivative approach is, it will be using two-dimensional derivative computation. So that is another one point of derivative approach. So next thing is pattern fitting approach. So pattern fitting approach in the sense, a series of approximating functions in the form of edge template over the small neighborhood will be taken into analysis. So we will be calculating the parameters. So how we will be calculating the parameters is that the properties that is having the best fitting functions will be taken into consideration, and that will be made to determine. So this is how the pattern fitting works. So let's see about neighborhood operations. So neighborhood operations is nothing but it will be operating on larger neighborhood of pixels than point operations. Okay. So instead of a particular point, we will be choosing the pixel values that is present around that particular pixels. Say for an example, if I am choosing a particular pixel that is x comma y in the given image, you can see that I am choosing the pixel x comma y. I am also choosing the neighborhood pixels that is present along the x and y, along horizontal and vertical directions. That is, neighborhoods are almost a rectangle around a center pixel. So that is, any size of rectangle and any shape filter can be used for this particular neighborhood operations. So I am taking this along x and y axis. So for each pixel in the origin, we will be calculating the values that are present around the neighborhood pixel value, and all those sum of that pixel value will be replaced in the image, that is x comma y value will be replaced with a new pixel value. That new pixel value is equal to the sum of the pixel values present around the pixel that we have chosen for consideration. Okay, So after that, the image will be getting out, changed to image g of x comma y. Before processing, the image will be considered as f of x comma y. So next thing is, there are three type of edge direction, as I told you earlier, that is point, a line, and edge detection. So segmentation will be based upon detecting sharp and local changes in the intensity, that is from darker level to lighter level. Okay, so this pixels will be having an intensity which changes abruptly. Okay, so abruptly in the sense, there will be a sudden change from one intensity level to another intensity level, that is, it can be changed either from lower intensity to higher intensity or from higher intensity to lower intensity suddenly. Okay, so there will not be a gradual change, there will be a sudden change. So that particular thing is called as edge. Okay, so this particular edges together form and connect of edge pixels. So that is called as edge pixels. Next thing is line. So how we are taking this line is, it can be viewed by the edge segment, so in which the intensity of background will be either the side of the line, that is either much higher or much lower than the intensity of line pixels. Similarly, point, in the sense, we all know that point, in the sense, it is a particular thing. So that is, the isolated point can be viewed as a line whose length or width will be equal to one pixel. So this is the definition of point, a line, and detect. So next thing is, local averagings will cause the image to get smoothened, and average will be analogous to integration. Okay, so this abrupt and local changes and intensities can be detected by using either first order or second order derivatives. So we have some set of criteria or conditions for both first order and second order derivatives. So derivatives of this digital functions is defined in terms of their differences. So now let's see what are the criteria or terms and conditions for this first derivative and second derivative. So for first derivative, it must be zero at the areas of constant intensity, and it must be zero at the onset of an intensity step or ramp. And third condition is that it must be a non-zero at the points along the intensity ramp. Similarly, for second derivative, we have sets of criteria or conditions. So that is, it must be zero in areas of constant intensity, and second point is, it must be non-zero at the onset and end of an intensity step or ramp. And similarly, in the third point, it must be zero along the intensity ramp. So as we are why we are going for these two derivative conditions is that, since we are dealing with the digital quantities, these values should be made finite. Okay, so the maximum possible intensity value should be very finite. So that's why I'm going for choosing this two particular approximation for my first derivative as well as for second derivative. So this is the simplification profile of all those three types of detection, that is point, line, and edge. So you can see that the ramp spans over the four pixels, and the noise point is present in the single pixel. The line is 3 pixel is thick, and the transition that takes place between the adjacent pixels is noted clearly in the graph, and the number of intensity levels was limited to 8 for simplicity. You can go for using any number of pixels. Since to simplify my calculations, I have considered my pixel value to 8. Okay, so you can see how this first order derivative and second order derivative is given according to the approximations which we saw in the previous slide. So this is how I am marking my image in the grayscale. So in the left side, you can note down the intensity. So now it's your turn, students. Quiz question based on edge detection. So first thing is, edge detection is based on abrupt changes, smooth changes, thickness of edge, and thinness of edge. So now you answer the question. I hope you all had a very useful session. Thanks for watching my video.